So let us see the impact of the IFRS application in the we can call the extract from the financial position. Then this is profit or loss. The extract would be, so we do have only two things in the profit or loss account. And we do have here the year 2019 and 2018 comparative year. So this would be the depreciation of right of use asset, abbreviation only. How much the depreciation for right of use asset in 2019 equal here 2019 and 2018 as well, the same amount, because the depreciation is depreciation charge over the lease term would be the same amount, or we can would be the same amount. The depreciation for the third year, and then we have the interest interest for lease liability in the 2019. The interest charge would be this amount, and in the 2018 the interest charge was this amount. So total sum of the interest and depreciation is round off. None. So if we see this amount is equal to the our earlier calculate is equal to the our earlier calculation. So this minus the total of this amount, the therefore be zero, and this minus 2018 third year would be zero. So we have done with the full retrospective method. So as I said before, this is a huge world, but it gives you the details how your the lease contract started, and you restate all the interest things your the lease contract started. So the good things, the comparability. So we have the comparison. So we do have the comparisons between these 3 years, and here we do have the comparisons between these 2 years. So it is a huge work, and so let's see the easiest one, and it is your choice whether you need to apply the full retrospective approach or the modified retrospective approach.